After her regular pregnancy months, 27-year-old Fiona Naruwama had expected the delivery of the baby to be smooth, but this wasn't the case. Recounting the disturbing details of her near death due to prolonged childbirth, Naruwama acquired fistula. Because of the gravity of the complication, Naruwama proved incurable even after three operations.
Operated over three times until I was deemed incurable. But at some point, for advocacy reasons, I do tell the public that I am okay so that we can woo more women to come out from the villages they are hiding to get free treatment, because it depends on the extent of the damage that a specific mother got that can rule out their recovery rate.
Naruwama, a fistula warrior, is now living with coping mechanisms such as urinal catchments and adult diapers. Because of this condition, she had to switch her career from journalism to advocacy as a fistula ambassador, identifying with victims and sensitizing young girls and women in communities about the condition.
I was offered a scholarship with the Minister of Health, stroke UNFPA, to go back to school and do midwifery so that I can easily survive in the fistula campaign as a midwife, so that I can also be part of the nurses who are fighting fistula in Uganda ethically, rather than being only an expert client.
During the fistula advocacy meeting in Kampala, the senior consultant surgeon working with Soroti Main Hospital, Fred Chira, disclosed that the factors responsible for fistula have changed over the years, from obstructed labor to caesarean section errors, though he preferred terming them as accidental injuries.
The fistula that we get today are the ones that are called in medical speak iatrogenic, mainly, and those are fistula which are caused as a result of accidental injury to the urinary bladder, to the urethra, to the ureters. As doctors operate these women, take out babies, mainly at caesarean section or pelvic surgery as they remove the uterus. So that contribution of such cases is becoming more prominent compared to the one where it is strictly due to obstructed labor.
According to the World Health Organization, Uganda ranks third amongst countries with the greatest burden of obstructed fistula, with 75,000 women living with the condition not treated.
And yet, our capacity to treat fistula is about 2,000, between 2,000 and 3,000 women a year. You realize that is it would take us several years if we are to completely eradicate this condition at that rate.
You know what we are doing today? We are trying to look at how much is government giving, how much are the partners putting in the basket, and how much are the other stakeholders coming in with, so that we know that this is a total amount of money that we have, and now we plan how to use that money.
Treating obstructed fistula remains very costly, which has left many women in terrible conditions.